Republicans on the House Oversight Committee, led by Committee Chair Republican James Comer, actually kind of lucked out this week that they had scheduled a press conference for Wednesday morning to lay out all the alleged crimes of Hunter Biden and pretty much, according to them, the entire Biden family. And the reason I say they lucked out is because that news was tremendously overshadowed by the 13-count indictment that was unsealed that morning when Republican Representative George Santos surrendered himself to authorities in the city of New York. Because most of the media was focused on Santos, a lot of the media was not paying attention to the fact that Republicans held a press conference to announce that they have absolutely no evidence of criminal wrongdoing against the Biden family. Now, they insisted during this press conference, they believe that crimes were committed, but when pressed on whether or not they have evidence of actual criminal wrongdoing, they admitted, no, we don't. It's not just me, by the way, that's saying that. This is pretty much the general consensus among all media outlets, the New York Times, Washington Post, everything on the left. And believe it or not, even some media outlets on the right are calling out these Republicans for holding a press conference to announce that they got nothing. The folks at Fox News on Thursday morning decided to ask James Comer himself, the chair of the committee, what the hell are you doing? Like, why are you holding a press conference when you've got absolutely nothing? Steve Doocy from Fox and Friends particularly called out James Comer for having nothing after months and months of investigation. So take a look at Steve Doocy calling out James Comer to his face for basically being a pathetic failure. Here he is.
I know the Republicans said that the smoking gun were these financial records that you were able to subpoena and got your hands on. They show that some of the president's relatives were paid more than $10 million from foreign sources between 2015 and 2017. And your party, the Republican investigators, say that that's proof of influence peddling by Hunter and James. But that's just your suggestion. You don't actually have any facts to that point. You've got some circumstantial evidence. And the other thing is, of all those names, the one person who didn't profit is there's no evidence that Joe Biden did anything illegally.
Now, to be honest with you, I am shocked that James Comer even agreed to go on Fox News Thursday morning, because on Wednesday evening, he actually did go on Maria Bartiromo's show on Fox News, where she also asked him, what's your plan B? Because you got nothing. She asked him, what is your plan B? Because even a hard right individual like Maria Bartiromo is looking at this and saying, dude, you got nothing. You're lucky the media wasn't paying attention to you today, because you would have gotten spanked even harder than you're getting spanked right now. That's what Steve Doocy was pointing out. Now, to his credit, of course, James Comer, in the expanded version of that clip that I just showed you, then goes on to say, well, we're certain Biden's involved, President Biden. Like, we know he's involved. We know he's involved. But you literally have no evidence to prove that. So that is actually conjecture, which will not hold up in a court of law, and of course is definitely not enough to even create criminal charges against him. I'll say it before, because I say it every time I talk about this. If y'all have got evidence that Hunter Biden broke the law, charge him. Put him on trial. Let the jury decide. Like, I don't care. If he broke the law, please do charge him. Do not let him get away with it. But y'all have now been at this for months. You've held hearing after hearing. You've been working with the DOJ to the point where now they're like, listen, we don't even know what else we can do for you. You're now asking for stuff that we legally can't even give you, and this is getting ridiculous. We'll work with you, they said. We'll continue to work with you, but I don't know what more you guys want. Republicans are desperate. They see Hunter Biden behind every sinister thing that's happening in their little worlds. And in spite of months of investigations, in spite of years of speculation, you know, the laptop and all that crap, they got nothing. They have, as they've put it, a web of LLC corporations where millions of dollars was flowing. Okay? That's not illegal. making money even from foreign countries, unless they're, of course, on an embargoed list. That's not illegal. You're actually allowed to do that. So I don't know what point Republicans are trying to make, but the entire country right now, the left and apparently the right, are getting pretty damn sick of this. Either put up or shut up, because this is getting ridiculous.
Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.